right, welcome back to Coop's Collection. Today I've actually got someone else's collection. A good friend of mine, a childhood friend who I grew up with, gave me his original Pokemon collection. So you can see right here, he decorated the front of his binder. He's got Pikachu and Blastoise that he's drawn, and Butterfree. Lots of cool stickers on it, but he knows that I've been collecting Pokemon cards for a couple years now, since I've gotten back into it, and this has been sitting in his closet, so he decided to gift it to me, which is really exciting because he's got some pretty cool stuff in here. So I wanted to make a video going through his collection. I've actually already gone ahead and pulled out all of the holographic cards. So if we look at the binder, it's really going to be all bulk stuff, and I'm going to go through this off camera sometime, but he's got tons, and I can't even open it. There's just a lack of space here on the desk. So, got tons of bulk from base set two. There's fossil and jungle in here, and some of these sleeves or pages are just this thick in how many cards are in each slot. So there's tons and tons of bulk to go through. Got some non-holo rares, but all kinds of really good stuff. Got some Japanese cards even too. So I'm gonna be going through all this, not in this video, but outside of filming, to just kind of see what he's got in here. So some pretty cool stuff. But yeah, I'm excited to go through it. But I wanted to show, I wanted to show all of the holos, and I've actually already picked some out to send off to PSA because I think they're in good enough condition. So let me move this binder out of the way, and then we'll look over some of the holos that he had. All right, so let's start actually with some of the holos that I'm not going to be sending to PSA just because I don't think they're in quite good enough shape to justify kind of the grading fees and shipping them off. So we've got Clefable from Jungle. We've got a Japanese Meganium from Neo Genesis, a base set Mewtwo. We've got Pidgeot from Jungle Set, Vaporeon from Jungle. Actually, this is a Shadowless Machamp. And you can tell because if you look at a regular card, you see this drop shadow on the right-hand side. This actually does not have that drop shadow. So that's what a Shadowless card looks like. Unfortunately, this Machamp is pretty beat up. You can kind of see it's got some significant scratching on the holo end, even on just like the non-holo parts of the card. And then the back is pretty worn, but an awesome card nonetheless, a Shadowless Machamp. We've got a Poliwrath from base set, Ninetales from base set, Nidoking from base set, a Fossil Raichu, a Victory Bell from jungle, a Neo Genesis Feraligatr Japanese, a Dark Machamp from Japanese Rocket, Aerodactyl from Fossil, and a Kangaskhan from Jungle. So some pretty cool holos, and some of them are in decent shape. I just don't think from a pure cost benefit analysis that they're, it's worth necessarily sending off. So some have a little bit of light play on the back with some whitening, as well as a little bit of holo scratching and stuff. But anyway, those are some of the holos that didn't make the cut. But let's take a look at the 14 or so that did. I think it's about 14. So these I've already all sleeved up to send off in my next PSA submission. So we've got Lapras from Fossil, a Dark Gyarados from Rocket. This is the pre-release version. Regular Gyarados from base set. First edition Electrode from Jungle. Fossil Muk, one of the least popular Fossil Holo cards, which I guess I can understand that. Muk's just like a big pile of sludge, but I mean, a Holo's a Holo, so why not? Okay, I want to talk about this one. Let me put down the rest of the stack. This is a first edition Dark Dragonite, and this thing is clean. I don't see a single scratch on the holo. I mean, there may be a print line, and if you see something that looks like a scratch, it's most likely either on the card saver or on the sleeve, because I looked at this thing pretty significantly outside of the sleeves. But The hollow looks very, very good. I think the centering looks pretty decent. The border thicknesses aren't anything too crazy. The bottom might be a little thicker than the top, but the sides look pretty good. And then the back. I mean, the back is almost flawless. I think I see one thing, and that's going to be up here in the top left. That one little white dot right there. And then, I mean, again, the centering is pretty good. I think it's good enough on the back, at least, since there's a little more leeway. But all in all, this card, I think, has a shot at a PSA 10. I guess we'll just have to wait and find out, but that would be amazing. If not, this is absolutely going to be a 9, because I cannot find a single thing wrong with it. So, very, very excited. Send off a first edition Dark Dragonite. Then we got a couple ones you might recognize. Base set Charizard. Not as clean, unfortunately, but still a pretty good Charizard nonetheless. A little bit of whitening on the back. Probably a solid 6, maybe a 7. A little bit of silver on the front as well. Got Blastoise. A little Blastoise action to go along with it. This one actually looks pretty good. Clean holo on the front. On the back. Good, a little off-centered. A little bit of whitening again in the top left here. But nothing too crazy. I think this one's got a shot at a 9. Probably not a 10. I mean, I won't hold my breath, but that'd be pretty cool too. There's Blastoise. And then you can't have the big 3 without Venusaur. The biggest boy. So, again, pretty decent holo. Nothing too crazy. Some print lines. And then a relatively good back there. I think it's got, I don't know, like right here, that whitening is on the card. It's almost like it's a scuff mark. So I'm not sure how much they'll take off for that. I definitely won't get a 10, but I don't know if that'll knock it all the way to an 8 or not. We'll see. So there's Venusaur. Then we've got a couple Japanese cards that were in really good shape. We've got Erica's Vileplume from one of the gym sets. We've got Sabrina's Gengar. A Fossil Raichu. We've got Rocket Zapdos, which is a really, really cool card. I looked over this one. Again, just absolutely clean holo. So really excited to send this one off as well. I think it's got a really good shot at a 10. Back looks pretty much flawless. Not seeing any whitening or anything on the edges. So Rocket Zapdos. And then the last one from this collection is the Neo Celebi here in Japanese. Really, really cool holo pattern on it. I think it's so cool because it's like a planet in the background, right? So she's like in space, which is pretty cool. So there's Celebi again. The back looks really nice. Japanese cards just hold up so much better over time, it seems like, than their English counterparts. So really nice to get a hold of some pretty cool cards to include in the next PSA submission batch. So like I said, I'm going to go through all the bulk that is in the binder, but I'd already kind of filtered out some of the holos and a pretty good amount that I think are worth sending. So we've got 14 or so here that'll be in the next submission batch. You might see these again soon. But again, shout out to Joe, my childhood friend who gave me this, which is pretty awesome. So appreciate that, bud. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. That's what I've got today. Appreciate it. If you like this video, go ahead and smash that like button. It really helps me out. If you like this sort of content, go ahead and subscribe to my channel so you get notified when I post new videos. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.